Welcome to U.S. Eagle Claw YouTube channel. The sudden and effective operations of the Ukrainian army in the last days transformed the war in Eastern Europe into a completely different phase. In particular, air and missile attacks came to the fore even more in this relentless war. The Ukrainian army has increased its attack range by modifying the unmanned aerial vehicles in its arsenal. Thanks to this, the possibility of using these drones by the Kiev Air Force in the cross-border operations against Moscow has emerged. We should also not forget the gods of war used by the Ukrainian armed forces. HIMARS long-range missile systems, which are currently threatening Crimea and its surroundings, are known as the war beasts that Russian troops fear the most. Pressurized attacks by Kiev prompted Russian leader Vladimir Putin to retaliate attacks. However, the air defense systems and other military equipment in the Ukrainian army greatly neutralized these counterattacks organized by the Moscow army. Conflicts in Ukraine have escalated in recent weeks despite the effective military materials of the Kiev army. Russian attacks damaged southern cities such as Odessa. These brutal attacks by Putin's soldiers left residents without electricity for a long time as the winter season began. Ukrainian President Volodymyr Zelensky confirmed in a statement that about 1.5 million people in Odessa and its environs were left without electricity after an overnight attack by Russian forces. Despite this setback, the statement also stated that the majority of Iranian drones used to carry out the attack were shot down. Regarding the attacks of the invading troops that started in the south of Ukraine, Zelensky said, "Russian invading troops used a total of 15 Shahed unmanned aerial vehicles against Odessa. The attacks, which started on Saturday, continued for an uninterrupted night. The real attitude of Russia towards the inhabitants of Odessa consists entirely of deliberate bullying, attempts to bring disaster to the city. Our sky defenders managed to shoot down 10 out of 15 drones. Well done." While Zelensky and other Ukrainian officials' timelines differ, repairs to the region's electricity grid are expected to take longer than usual due to the intensity of attacks from Moscow. But heavy attacks against Russian forces began in other parts of the south of Ukraine. As a result of the brutal Russian interventions in the city of Odessa, the Ukrainian armed forces started breathtaking dawn operations and counterattacks. The successful offensive movements of the Kiev army in the southern region of Ukraine, which intensified the other day, shook the agenda. Using high-mobility artillery rocket systems in Ukraine, he turned the military barracks of the Moscow army in the Russian-occupied city of Melitopol into a fireplace. The attacks of the Ukrainian army continued for a long time in this Russian military barracks, where very severe attacks were experienced. These sudden attacks, which caught the Moscow troops unprepared, proceeded successfully thanks to the HIMARS long-range missile systems in Ukraine's inventory. Ukrainian artillery fired dozens of missiles at the Russian military base in Melitopol. Huge fires broke out in every area where HIMARS missiles hit this barracks. Pro-Moscow officials said last Saturday night two people were killed and 10 injured in attacks in the occupied Zaporizhia region in southeast Ukraine and the military barracks in Melitopol. However, Ukrainian authorities reported that as a result of these attacks, about 200 invaders were killed or injured. Evgeny Belitsky, the regional governor of Zaporizhia founded by Russia, announced on his Telegram channel that air defense systems destroyed two missiles, but four of them reached their targets. Belitsky stated that an entertainment center where civilians eat was completely destroyed in the attack with HIMARS missiles. HIMARS was among Ukraine's most formidable weapons in the war, allowing forces to hit large numbers of targets with precision. Vladimir Rogov, one of the senior members of the administration established by Russia in the Zaporizhia region, shared images of the building engulfed in flames. The statements of the Russian authorities seem very inadequate considering the severity of the attacks. The exiled mayor of Melitopol, Ivan Fedorov, announced that about 200 people were killed or injured as a result of the attacks carried out by the Kiev army in and around Melitopol. The Ukrainian armed forces, after their remarkable success in Melitopol and surrounding cities in the south of the country, turned their route to Donetsk. Ukrainian forces repelled Russian attacks near the city of Bakhmut. The Moscow army's focus on the iconic city of Bakhmut caught the attention of Zelensky's soldiers. Russian forces have carried out a number of offensive operations in this region, especially in recent weeks. Realizing the danger, the Kiev soldiers had to shift part of their special forces to Bakhmut and its environs. With the concentration of Russian troops in the aforementioned city, the soldiers of the Kiev army determined the positions and military bases of the invading troops. The Moscow army, on the other hand, was still carrying out small operations against the city of Bakhmut. A Russian Mail blogger claimed that Moscow army forces continued to attack Ukrainian fortifications near Bakhmut, where they reportedly had little tactical success. Another Russian Mail blogger, in his recent assessment of the ISW in Bakhmut, pointed out that Putin's troops have not yet captured Opudny and that offensive operations in Bakhmut are likely to be curtailed due to high costs in the near term. The ISW also announced that Russian troops carried out offensive operations in Avdiivka and Donetsk City area last week. Meanwhile, Ukrainian authorities claim to have repelled Russian attacks southwest of Avdiivka. According to the ISW report, Russian President Vladimir Putin risked losing the support of proxy leaders in this region after forces failed to remove Ukrainian soldiers from the artillery field of the city of Donetsk. Igor Girkin, a veteran of the Russian army and former defense minister of Donetsk, was among those who directly criticized the Moscow leaders. Girkin argued that Putin's statements on December 9th, which described the progress of the special military operation as stable, were untrue. In a Telegram message, Igor Girkin said, "Putin assured us that special military operations is proceeding normally, calmly, according to plan. But this time, he did not add anything that it was ahead of schedule." In addition, in the assessment, the ISW claimed that Russian authorities are planning to launch programs in Russia and the occupied territories of Ukraine to prepare minors for final military service. Russia tried to consolidate the gains it gained after its invasion of the Eastern European country at the end of February by annexing Ukraine's regions. But the unparalleled resistance and counterattack of the Kiev soldiers dashed the dreams of the Moscow army. Putin's army, which has suffered heavy losses in the last period in most of Ukraine's fronts, received deep wounds. In fact, due to these losses, Kremlin spokesman Dmitry Peskov made striking statements accepting the superiority of Ukraine. Peskov explained that Russia has no plans to seize more territory from Ukraine. A news report from Ukraine last Sunday revealed that the headquarters of the leading Russian mercenary group was badly damaged in an attack, dealing another blow to President Vladimir Putin's increasingly besieged invasion. The news in question was about the events in the city of Kadivka in the Luhansk region, where the Wagner mercenary group set up headquarters in a hotel. Luhansk Governor Serhii Haidai said that the hotel was targeted by Ukrainian forces and that the private military contractors of the Wagner group suffered heavy losses. According to the governor, half of these contractors in the mercenary group died as a result of the attack. The Wagner Group is a state-sponsored mercenary unit charged with numerous war crimes and abuses on orders from the Kremlin. Over the years, this criminal organization has been deployed to wartime regions such as Crimea, Syria, Libya, Mali, and the Central African Republic. Evgeny Prigozhin, Putin's close ally and Russian oligarch in charge of Wagner, confirmed that neither he nor his son Pavel were at the hotel after the attack. While the Ukraine-Russia war continues to witness very interesting events, the leaders of both countries now want clear gains. While Zelensky thinks that this war will end as soon as possible and that his country will return to its former full independence days, Russian leader Vladimir Putin is after developing aggressive policies to take much more land from Ukraine. In the following processes, we will see which side will be successful. Please do not forget to subscribe to our channel and turn on notifications in order to be informed about new videos. Thank you for watching us.